वंदे गुरुपद्द्वंदम भक्तबिंद समन्वितम श्रीचैतन्य प्रभु वंदे नितानंद सहोदितम श्री नंद नंदन वंदे राधिका चरणोदयम् गोपीजन समायुक्त बिंदावन मनोहर वांछाकल्पतरुवश्य कृपासिन्धुवच पतितानं पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः मूकं करोति वाचालं पंगुं लंघयति गिरिं यत्कृपातमहं वन्दे परमानन्दमाधव वृंदावई तुलसीदेव वै पियावै केशवस्य च कृष्णभक्तिपदे देवी सत्त्वतत्त्वयी नमो नमः नारायण नमस्कृत नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयो मुदीर संकीर्तने कृष्ण कथोपदेश गौरी पत्रस्य प्रकाशने च सदानुरक्त गुरुभक्ति युक्तो भक्ति प्रमदाक्ष जगोद्वरुन धैयम् सदा परिभवग्नमविष्टदोहम् तीर्थास्पदम् शिव विरिञ्चिनुतम् शरण्यम् भीतातिहम् पुनतोपाल भवाद्दिपूतम् वंदे महापुरुषते चरणारविन्दम् यत्पाद पल्लवनख चंदमनि छटाया विस्फुरजित किमपि गोपवधूष्वदर्श पूर्णानुरागरस सागर सारमूर्ति साराधिका मयि कदा कृपां करोषि श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौरभक्तबिंद श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिव सदी गौरभक्तबिंद हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे आजानुलंबित भुजौ कनकाबुदातु संकीर्तनैकवितरु कमलायताक्षु विश्वाम्बरु द्विजवरु जुगधर्मपालु वंदे जगत प्रिय करु करुणावतारु हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे 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 राम 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 हरे नमामि गंगे तव पाद पंकजं सुरासुरैर्वंदितो दिव्यरूपं भुक्तिं च मुक्तिं च ददासि नित्यं भावानुरूपेण सदा नरानं गंगातरंगरमणीयजटाकलापं गौरीनिरन्तरविभूषितवामभागं नारायणो प्रियमनंगमदापहारं वाराणसीपुरपति भजवीशनाथं वागीशाजस्य वदने लक्ष्मीर्जस्य च वक्षसि यस्यास्ति हृदये संवित् त्वं नृसिंहमहं भजे हरे कृष्ण 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 हरे हरे Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare. Sansaru Sindhu Uttarani Hidayanjadi Sad Sankirtanam Ritarasi Ramate Manoshe Vemam Budho Viharani Jadi Chitta Viti Chaitanya Chanda Charani Kurutanuragam Chaitanya Chanda Charani Kurutanuragam Sansaru Sindhu Uttarani Hidayanjadi Sad Sankirtanam Ritarasi Ramate Manoshe Pemam Budho Viharani Jadi Chitta Viti Chaitanya Chanda Charani Kurutanuragam Chaitanya Chanda Charani Kurutanuragam Gauriya Goshthipati Sri Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada told, Bhagavan is Aprakita, Supreme Lord is Aprakita, inconceivable, we cannot imagine. Anything we are thinking, anything we are looking, if we want to get actual meaning, we like to go to our experience bank. Whatever we see, new thing, we go to our experience bank to search, to get support. Material thing and aprakito, transcendental things, are not same, just opposite. So, somebody asking to Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada, have you seen Supreme Lord? Prabhupada giving answer to him, what it concern to you? If I have seen Supreme Lord, what you can gain? If I have not seen Supreme Lord, what it concern to you? First point is that you like to see Supreme Lord or not? You like to see Supreme Lord or not? Then I can speak something to you. Actually, Aprakita Vastu, Guru Vaishnav, Bhagavat Tattva, in total. Bhagavat Tattva mean Adyay Gyan Tattva mean total. Bhagavat Tattva mean Naam, Dham, Parikar, Vaishishta, Paraparanalya, everything, all in total, is called Adyay Gyan Tattva, total, which is inconceivable. Inconceivable mean we cannot even think, it's not possible. Because we have no experience about transcendental world. We have no experience about transcendental world. So if we think what you can think, what we can think out what? That is the main problem. But Prabhupada speaking, though Supreme Lord is inconceivable, aprakita, you cannot understand, you cannot see, you cannot feel, still possible. How? When all your sense organ, including your mind, get busy in seva. Sevan mukhehi yuhayam swayameva spurtyada. Atah krishna namadi na bhavet grajyam indri. Sevan mukhehi yuhayam adu swayameva spurtyada. Aprakita harinam and hari. Prabhupada many times used to speak that to do harinam, that to do harinam and to meet with Krishna, Hari, all the same. So actually, it is inconceivable, mean we cannot think, never we can get. Yato bacha nivartante aprapta manasa saho. So we can put our personal effort, all your money power, manpower, everything, educational power, thinking power, everything, but we cannot come out successful. Nayam atma pravachanena labhya na maidhaya na bahu na sutena jam eva esha vinite tena labhya. That's why in Upanishad it is saying that you cannot understand, but you can understand, but you can see, but you can feel everything. When all your sense organ, including your mind, can get busy to do seva. Now question is that how seva is possible? I can try to do seva. Seva is not such a chief thing that you can plan and start doing seva. Until and unless you are going to meet a Sadguru, you cannot start seva. Even you cannot start Hari Bhajan. Prabhupada speaking, most of the people thinking that we can meet with Supreme Lord, that's why we are doing bhajan. But they forget, if they have no Guru Darshan, if they have no Guru Darshan, how they can meet with Supreme Lord? At all there is no Guru Darshan in their heart. They are always thinking material thing and about Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, always. How it is possible that Guru Vaishnava Prakita, these are Supreme Lord of Prakita. We can discuss this point under the guidance of Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupada. Actually, Bhagavat Tattva, Nam Tattva, Guru Tattva, all Akhanda Tattva. Akhanda Tattva and you are Khandita Tattva. I mean, Supreme Lord is Akhanda Tattva and all Jiva are Amsa. So, Amsa doesn't mean that those Jivas are the counterpart of Supreme Lord. That doesn't mean. If you think that Supreme Lord is undivided Tattva, Akhanda Tattva, so all Jivas, they are actually counterpart of Supreme Lord. If you think that way, then totally wrong. Jivatma, all Jivas, they are not counterpart, because Purna Vastu, Bhagavat Tattva, and there is counterpart, that is also Purna. From Purna Vastu, if you take anything if you take from Purna Vastu, even one dust particle from Purna Jagat, it also Purna. But this world is not Purna Jagat, always full of deficiency, dissatisfaction, complaint, you know, dirty darshan, always we are busy. So actually those jivas, they are full of dissatisfaction, doubts. How they can cut their doubts and ignorance? There is the main question. From outside country, actually from Spain, different question coming to me, I was giving answer, is also related. How we can know it is Mahaprasadam? How we can understand that it is Guru Vaishnava is aprakita? All these different kind of question coming. Parshadas of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, how we can know they are transcendental aprakita? A different kind of question coming, so we will have to discuss this point. So, Bhagavat Tattva is Akhanda Tattva, and all Jivas, they are not counterpart of Bhagavat Tattva, because counterpart of Bhagavat Tattva means also Purna Vastu. Because in Upanishad we know Purnasya Purna Madhaya Purnameva Avasishvati. From Purna Vastu, if we take something Purna, then also residue also Purna. So we cannot play our brain to understand this point. Inconceivable. Govardhan coming here in this material world, Govardhan coming. But still Govardhan is there in aprakita jagat, I mean Vaikuntha, in Golok Vrindavan, there. So this is the main question. So many times I give answer before, I already gave answer, that Jivas are not counterpart. Ansa means Sakti Ansa. Mamaiva Ansa Jiva Loke Jiva Bhuto Sanatanaha. Mamaiva Eva means affirmative. The Jiva, be sure, the Jiva are Amsa. Mamaiva Amsa. Men, Supreme Lord speaking, Mamaiva Amsa Jiva Loki Jiva Huto Sanatana. Those Jivas are my Amsa. Amsa means not Purna Vastu and from Purna Vastu Amsa, not that. Shakti, Bhagavat Tattva and his Shakti Tattva is there, Bhagavat Tattva and Shakti Tattva all non-different from each other, Achinta Vedavet Tattva. So, in that case, Bhagavan speaking this way, because Shakti Tattva and Bhagavat Tattva are non-different from each other. That's why Bhagavan speaking, Mama Ivamsa Jiva Luke Jiva Votosana. That's mean Shakti Ansa. Bhagavat Shakti, Tatasta Shakti Ansa. Jo bhi hai. Okay. But actually, now we have doubt. Popa speaking, when we can meet with Supreme Lord, because all we leave our country, all our property, we coming here to get satsanga, everything, but still our darshan is so dirty, our darshan is so dirty, we cannot see anything aprakita. Srila Madhavendra Puripad passing stool, urine in bed, but still Ishwar Puripad never going to find any fault with Gurudev. Whereas Ramchandra Puri wanted to find fault with Gurudev. He is feeling some dissatisfaction is there in Guru. Sometime Guru Vaishnava acting this way, doing Leela. So if we develop dirty darshan, then never we can meet Supreme Lord. Because I already told the Prabhupada speaking, first of at all, if we have Guru Darshan, if we at all have Guru Darshan, perfect Guru Darshan, then and only then the question of Bhagavad Darshan coming. What to speak more? If we are actually not taking Diksha properly from Gurudev, Guru Tattva, if we are not established in Guru Tattva, we don't understand Guru Tattva, then our Bhagavad Bhajan cannot even start. He cannot start Hari Bhajan. It's a big problem. Prabhupada speaking, actually, we can meet with Supreme Lord, we can get Nitya Seva, when we can feel that my Guru Pad Padma, of course, should be a Prakita Guru, not a material Guru, as with different desires, he is, you know, showing different kind of moods, and Shishya can think, because he can think 100%, that is my Gurudev is Sadguru. He can think, who is going to stop him? So I am not speaking about that, actual Sadguru. If actual Prabhupada speaking, if you are going to understand that my Guru Pad Padma, Sadguru Pad Padma is just equal to Gauranga Mahaprabhu, the day you can realize this point, that my Guru Pad Padma is Gauranga Mahaprabhu, just Gauranga Mahaprabhu, that day you can get the scope to start seva. Prabhupada speaking, from that day, you can start seva. So actually, Prabhupada speaking, when you can realize the point that my Guru Pad Padma is Shakshad Haritena Samasta Sastaish Ruktastata Bhabhateva Sadvi Kintu Bhavurja Priyavatasya is the most, you know, dear, you know, associates of Bhagavan. And just topmost, you know, if you can think this way, then Radha Govinda Leela. First of all, what Prabhupada speaking, the day you can feel that Gaurang, my Guru Pad Padma is just equal to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. He is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself coming. If you can feel, then you can start Hari Bhajan. Then Harinam, you can come into your tongue. Harinam can dance. In that case, Prabhupada speaking, you can gradually feel that the topmost personal associates of Bhagavan and Gauranga Mahaprabhu. Then automatically through Harinam you can go on feeling all Leela of Bhagavan Sikhan. Gradually, not at a time. Gradually you can feel. First of Harinam can come and touch your heart. Some devotee asking, he is actually going to ask me, is it possible for us to do Harinam at all? Or in a material stage, how we can do Harinam, is at all possible? I said, no. Actually, through Seva, Guru Seva, you will have to develop your feeling that you are not material body. You will have to feel this gradually. then when you can feel that, when you can feel that you are not body, and chinmaya bhav can, you can feel, and you can go on doing sadguru seva, so gradually this kind of conception feeling coming in, then you can start harinam. In bonded stage actually a prakita harinam is not possible, and also to do harinam you also need sadhu sangha. Sadhu sanghe krishna naam ei matro chai, sansar jinite ar kono bostu na. That's mean you cannot go to a solitary place and start harinam, can do harinam, not that. Suppose you are going to serve the Supreme Lord, still you will have to do this seva under the guidance of a pure devotee. If you like to do harinam, you will have to do under the guidance of pure devotee. Anything you are going to do under the guidance of Shuddha Bhakta. Shuddha Bhakta can help you, then you can gradually increase your consciousness, not before that. Now different kind of doubts coming to contaminate our hearts, you know. First of all, how it is possible that rice, dal, sabji all become a prakita prasadam? How is that possible? Because all rice, dal, sabji we buy from market and we cook and offer to Krishna, all material Maharaj. Everything in this material world is material. So if we offer, how it become mahaprasadam, aprakita, chinmaya mahaprasad? Because all the time we are, you know, speaking this word, prasada seva korite hai sakala prapancha jay. Whenever we are going to take prasadam, be sure we are going to cut all material bondage. We can get in connection with the Supreme Lord. Prasada seva korite sakala prapancha jay. You can defeat maya very easily. Prapancha jaya means you can go out of maya, and so long as you are inside maya, then you cannot start hari bhajan. That means prasad, you will have to distribute prasadam, is the advice of Prabhupada. Prabhupada often used to say prasad ditya have, you will have to distribute prasad. But this word only Prabhupada can speak. One material acharya, one material, you know, sadhu, totally material, he can arrange prasadam, but that prasadam not going to give result. Because first point is that from which source those raw materials coming. Second point, who is cooking, and at all he is doing 1 lakh harinam or not, or at all Sadguru Dev is there or not, you know, who is going to offer. If Mahabhagavat going to offer something to Krishna, then Krishna is bound to accept. Patram puspam palam phalam toyam jome bhaktya prajachati is written. And Bidurani, when giving skin of banana, Krishna's eating. And when Bidur coming, Bidur asking, why you are doing this way? You are giving skin? Krishna laughing. I am not eating banana, I am not eating skin, I am not eating anything. I only like to get the taste of prema from devotees. So though Krishna is, you know, self-sufficient, there is no dissatisfaction is there. Try to understand this point. Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, they are totally satisfied tattva, saturated tattva, totally saturated. You cannot find any dissatisfaction inside Guru Vaishnava. You cannot find any dissatisfaction inside Krishna. But still, Krishna always want to get the new taste of love, prema. It is one, you know, one kind of, you know, Satantra Bhagavan, Sarat. So always and every time Krishna like to see that new jivatma. New Jivatma coming to save me, coming to serve me under the guidance of Sadguru Vaishnava. They also become Chinmay, because under the guidance of Sadguru they are trying. So it is the desire of Krishna, though Krishna is totally satisfied tattva. Still, it is a desire of Krishna to see new Jivatma can come and play with me. I like to get the taste because countless Jivatma, all Jivatma, they have different kind of attitude according to their previous sanskar. Even if we are going to consider about devotees, okay, maybe genuine devotees, countless genuine devotees are there in transcendental world. We can go through Shastra, we can find this Maharaj, this Boli Maharaj used to do this bhajan, Hanumanji Maharaj, this way, Parikshit Maharaj, Pitu Maharaj, all countless. But be sure, all of them, everybody, they have some speciality. So Krishna want to enjoy this speciality of love. Parikshit Maharaj has some speciality, Uttarama has some speciality, Kunti Devi has some speciality. All Sanatana Goswami wanted to establish someday, if I am going to live more, because day by day I don't know what going to happen. So I like to discuss. So you can see countless devotees, they have different kind of taste. According to their own taste, they are going to say serve Supreme Lord different way. So Krishna like to get test all the time. Even Krishna sometime want to get different kind of rasa. Krishna like to get different kind of rasa because Krishna himself is the source of all rasa. Krishna himself is the source of all rasa. But still, Krishna is the source of all rasa, Maharaj. Then why Krishna want to? You foolish, you don't try to understand this point. Though Krishna is the source of all rasa, but still one siddhanta is there in Upanishad, ekaki naiva ramate. If I want to get one rasa, for getting this rasa, I like to get some friends, associates. So together, even those who are drinking wine or this, they also, they like to invite two or three or four, Then they enjoy. So what is rasa tattva is such a thing that alone you cannot get test. So you have to get the association. So Krishna sometime feeling that I like to enjoy this because he can, though he is totally satisfied tattva or the agyanta, still Krishna can express desire. I like to get some, bir rasa. Who is going to give me this, exchange this bir rasa with me? So I like to exchange bir rasa. And now his problem, who can exchange bir rasa with Krishna? Who can fight with Krishna? We are teeny creature. In that case, Krishna plan in Vaikuntha Jagat there, actually Joy Vijay, Krishna wanted to get bir rasa. Joy Vijay speaking, Prabhu, naturally you are, saturated tattva, still some desire can come inside your heart sometime. It is one kind of leela. So we cannot bear it. So at all any desire inside your heart, we are going to help, we are going to serve you. Whatever you like to do, we can do. So according to the desire of Narayana, they are actually coming down in this material world. And they enter into the womb of Diti. Now so many questions. Those who are doing actual Hari Bhajan, they have fine accuracy. Fine accuracy, they can think up to that level. Maharaj, already we know that these my topics can today cover all things. Previous day I wanted to discuss time, space and matter. In this material world interrelated, but aprakita jagat, I can come and touch this point, or the tattva. Actually, point is that jadgatya non-ivartante tad dhyamam paramam man. So material people, those who are not enjoying Sadguru kipa, we cannot say that everybody taking diksha from Sadguru. We cannot say this way. Also, I have no fighting mood to fight with anybody. So you will have to be, very clever to understand this point. So everybody not going to enjoy Sadguru Kipa, first point. So naturally they are going to, if at all I am going to get Sadguru Kipa, then there cannot be any doubt inside me. There cannot be any doubt. Because Sadguru is so powerful, by the mercy of Sadguru, I can get all answer inside my heart. Even if Guru Vaishnava going to show something unusual events, but still I am not going to misunderstand. There is Sadguru Kipa, those who are enjoying, they can feel this way. Not everybody. So naturally, they can express doubts. By Maharaj, we heard actually that Jadgatya non-nivartante tadhyamam paramamma. How is that possible? Jayaviya was there in Vaikuntha Jagat, and how they fall down? That means there is no security. If we can do bhajan, how we can get security? Because everybody likes to get security. Regarding bank balance, regarding house and quarters, car, you know, protection, you know, external protection, they like to, everybody, they have this kind of mood. So they naturally going to put this kind of question. How is that possible, Maharaj? Joy Vijay actually is from Vaikuntha Parshad. Vaikuntha Parshad, they can fall down, is a new thing. So we cannot believe. What is the solution? But we heard that actually Joy Vijay fall down. They come in this material world. Hiranyakasipu, Hiranyakasipu, this, that. Okay. But actual point is that Joy Vijay, as per the desire of Supreme Lord, according to the desire of Supreme Lord, Joy Vijay coming down, it's okay. But not that Joy Vijay is actually fallen soul, not that. Try to understand. Because in front of Chatushan, Krishna already, Narayana already speaking. Chatushan speaking, we have done wrong, actually we give cards to. No, it was according to my desire. So, never mind. It is according to my desire. Brahmadanda, you speak cards them according to my desire. So now they come, now they are going to take birth in the material world. How is possible? Actually, Jiva Goswami was speaking, Vishwanath Chakravarti also explaining some different way. Jiva Goswami was speaking, actually Joy Vijay not going to leave their parshad body. It is new. It is miracle. If we think, we cannot believe. How is possible that Nitya Parshad can leave their body? Huh? How is possible? Jiva Goswami was giving answer. Actually, according to the desire of Narayana, they are coming down to exchange Bir Rasa with Prabhu. Because without Vaikuntha Parshad, who can exchange Bir Rasa? Because from Vaikuntha Jagat they are coming, they are Purna Vastu. They are coming to fight with Purna, Krishna, is possible. But actual point is that they are not going to leave their Parshad Deha. Be sure that they are not going to leave their Parshad Deha. Then, what is the solution? Jiva Goswami is speaking, same Deha, same body. Joy Vijay having same body, but they have anima, loghima, prakima, prakamo, different kind of yoga vibhuti. It's quite natural. Even demigods there in heaven, just in material world, in within this 14 world, they have this kind of, you know, yoga vibhuti. Also, I can discuss sometime that Kardam Rishi or, you know, or different kind of Rishi, they can show yoga vibhuti. So, that doesn't mean it's actually they are going to leave body. So not same body, out of their yoga vibhuti, they take fine form, like dust particle. Once, then they enter into the womb of Diti, this way. They enter into the womb of Diti this way. So Kashyap Muni, you know, arranging so that Diti can get baby shortly, but this was planning. It is the arrangement of Krishna, I mean Narayana. This way actually, Joy Vijay, same body, in fine form, they take the help of, Kardam Rishi and entering into the womb of Diti. This way, they are taking, fine form there inside, and they are not going to leave their own body. At the same time, externally, they are getting one material body, Joy Vijay. follow material body for Jayavijaya coming, Hiranyaka, Hiranyakashipu. So Hiranyaka, Hiranyakashipu, actually their external body, that is material body. So this way, each and every time different kind of question can come inside your heart to contaminate our heart. So first point is that if you are not going to enjoy the kripa of Sadguru, who is himself already there in transcendental realm. Materially you can find he is here, but always he is doing seva in aprakita jagat all the time. Prabhupada, this is the explanation of Prabhupada giving this Siddhanta. Who is Sadguru? Prabhupada giving explanation. He is Sadguru who is, you know, here in this material world. You can see his body, everything, to deliver us. At the same time, he has his existence already there in Vaikuntha Jagat. He is Sadguru who has his satta existence there in the aprakita jagat. But he is coming here to deliver us. So Acharya Mang Bijaniyat Nava Manet Karhichit, never try to dishonor, never try to insult. So Krishna speaking to Uddhavji Maharaj that I myself is Guru. Acharya Mang Bijaniyat Mam. I myself is Acharya, coming in the form of Acharya. Nava Manneto, never mentally even. If you have any material conception about Guru Vaishnava, 100% fall down. He can fall down. So, now different kind of question coming, I am going to give answer from Gaur Lila, Krishna Lila, different from Bhagavatam here, there. So, now point is that, how, first point I wanted to discuss. Somebody asking, Maharaj, how it is possible that rice, dal, chapati all become aprakita prasadam? All we are collecting from material world. I already told that first of all, you will have to understand, you will have to search what is the source of those chal, dal, chapati. Because if the source is contaminated, if the source is not perfect source, then in the beginning already, you are going to destroy all your program. Because you are making bhoga, everything you are booking, but all in the beginning all finish. Because the source is not pure, the source from which you collect everything is not pure. Then in the beginning it is all finished. The question is, chapter is closed. Now second point is that if at all the source is okay, not contaminated, Shukla Vritti. For Grihastha, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, Shukla Vritti. Shukla means white earning, no black, nothing. So, in this respect, Madhukuri Viksha, I am also still today depending on Madhukuri. I never like to take, amount from. So this way, even we are going to maintain so much purity, still some contamination can be there. Still, who knows? Regarding Vyasasan, regarding, food, prasadam, what contaminated having? Contamination is big danger. If contamination is somehow going to happen, then aprakita harikatha not possible. So, Guru Vaishnava always pure, they like to maintain purity, but still some problem can be there. So how rice, dal, chapati, and all ghee, all we collect from this material, how it become aprakita? First point in Kalikal, Bastu Shuddhi. Bastu mane items you are collecting is not pure. It cannot be pure. That is why Sankirtan Yajna is advised in Shastra. Because in Kalikal, Bastu Shuddhi is not possible. If you like to do Yajna, you are going to collect ghee, then it is fat inside that. So big problem. So you cannot do Yajna. All you are going to get oil and everything, you are paying double amount. Still there is no surety that it is pure. There can be some contamination. You are going to collect ghee, prawn, all different hybrid items. in the market available. Hybrid item is totally prohibited. It's not, we cannot offer it. Hybrid fruits, hybrid anything, not allowed. It's totally. So, anyway, so how we can understand? The first point is that the source should be pure, and who is going to cook? He is doing one like Harinam or not, or he is paid servant or not, and under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava, he is doing pure bhajan or not, why he is going to enter into kitchen, why he is going to enter into deity room. These all questions are concerned, involved in it. So then and only then, if one Maga, suppose Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj or Bangshidas Babaji Maharaj, though Bangshidas Babaji Maharaj externally from the fisherman's family, so if Bangshidas Babaji Maharaj is going to collect some brinjal or potato which people throw outside in market, he collect and, you know, very carefully cut and throw the useless portion and going to cook and wash in Ganga water and making one sabji and some rice. So do you think that Krishna going to throw it out? Because Bangshidas Babaji Maharaj is from Kaivartakul? Or do you think that Bangshidas Babaji Maharaj collecting it from market is useless and not fresh item, Krishna not going to accept? So if Bangshidas Babaji Maharaj or Gaur Kishor Babaji Maharaj used to offer raw rice, only raw rice with laban, some salt and raw rice, in Ganga washing and giving in front of Krishna and taking that and whole day doing Harinam. Vairagi kare sada nam sankirtan. So he is not established in nam sankirtan. If you stop nam sankirtan in the life of one pure sadhu, he is crying, want to die if he cannot speak Harikatha due to some problem. He is going to die, he like to die. So much pain he is feeling. Is the mood of Guru Vaishnava, because their heart is always singing Harikatha. Why not coming out? What problem can be there? Is the main question. There can be so many, you know, we know from the Leela of Guru Maharaj, Sridhar Maharaj, we know. So someday we can discuss this point. So now point is that if Mahabhagavat going to collect something, Madhukuri, and going to offer to Krishna, 100% Krishna going to take it. It has become Mahaprasadam. And if I, you know, I am a rich man, I am going to arrange Mahaprasadam for all, so it, how it is Mahaprasadam, you will have to calculate, because I have no right to discuss this way, because somebody can feel pain. So how it become Mahaprasadam? Source is not pure, who is cooking not pure, no mention any purity, nothing, no one like Harinam. Only Mahabhagavat when going to offer, or under the guidance of Mahabhagavat. Mahabhagavat giving me order, hey, you do one lakh harinam, okay, purity, impurity, I can think, you go, do this seva. Then by his power, it can be, you know, compromised. That is different things. You know, because Vaishnavira Abhidana Krishna Dayamai, Ehena Pamarapati Haiven Sadai, we know from Kirtan. So now Vishwanath Chakravarti was speaking, and some ordinary people also going to express doubt how chal dal, rice, chapati, dal become prasadam. Then answer is that all material what we are going to collect from this material world is actually really all material thing. But when we bring it and out of our devotion, there is a vital point. Vital point. Patram puspam phalam toyam jome bhaktya prayachati. Bhaktya, out of bhakti. Bhakti dara, bhakta mean it is third case ending in Sanskrit. Bhakti dara, by devotion. If you are going to offer it out of your strong devotion, you are going to offer Krishna, you will have to take it. Then automatically it become chinmay. Prasadam become chinmay. But you cannot feel. You cannot feel. That's why different kind of question coming. How then in Jagannath temple, when we are going to take prasadam, there is such rules and regulation that regarding Mahaprasadam, you should not think any negative thing all the time. Maybe some sudra going to touch this Mahaprasadam. Still it is not contaminated. Why? Why? Because it is Mahaprasadam. That it is not applicable all the time outside world. Meaning outside Jagannath temple, not always applicable. It is the commitment of Jagannath. That's why it is applicable there. It is 100% Mahaprasadam. So, Chinmay Vastu, what is transcendental, you know, things, you have no right to contaminate it. You have no right to contaminate it. One Acharya from Vrindavan, and he is big Acharya or not, that is up to you, you'll have to think. But he is acting as Acharya for a long time. He is the disciple of Bhaktivedanta Madhava Goswami Maharaj. One day in front of all devotees in Mayapur, all devotees sannyasis there, he is putting question, Maharaj, those Matajis, when they are sick, they can do Harinam or not? Because some Acharya speaking, no, you cannot touch. Some say speaking something. What is your opinion? I say it is not the question of opinion. It is a question of Siddhanta. The Siddhanta is that when they are sick, still they can go on doing Harinam in Harinam Mala, Tulsi Mala given by Gurudev. Because first point, Tulsi Mala is Vaikuntha Vastu. Tulsi Mala is Vaikuntha Vastu. So nobody can contaminate this Tulsi Mala. Not possible. It is not possible to contaminate. So they can go on doing Harinam after they become, you know, they recover. In that case, maximum they can wash with Ganga water and they can wash the big bed and again they can start Harinam. So anyway, they cannot start Harinam. It is not possible. Anytime they will have to do Harinam, they cannot stop Harinam. They just become very happy to hear this Siddhanta. So Mahaprasad, you can contaminate, it's not possible. So Mahaprasad is Mahaprasadam. When Mahaprabhu wanted to give Mahaprasadam, dry prasadam to Sarvama Bhattacharya in the just early in the morning, even when Sarvama Bhattacharya just get up, not going to wash mouth and take bath, nothing. He is kattar, he is very pakka. But still, Sarvama Bhattacharya, when Mahaprabhu was speaking, Sarvama, take this prasadam. Then in the bed he is sitting, he started eating. Then Mahaprabhu started dancing. Today, I climb actually, you know, Vaikuntha. Because Sarvama now believe in Mahaprasadam. So it is written, if Mahaprasad, Jagannath Mahaprasad, if you carry in France, Italy, America, any country, but still it is not contaminated. Durdeshanitam va parjushitam. Parjushitam means it is actually, it is just out of order externally. Some smell coming. But still, there is no disease. You cannot develop. So another point about Guru Vaishnava also, it is, Rupa Goswami Pad giving advice. I can discuss so many things one by one to prove that how it is possible that Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, they are aprakito. How we can believe all the parshadas of Gauranga Mahaprabhu, we find their samadhi, this, that, how it is possible? That we will have to discuss this point one by one. Now Rupa Goswami Pad wanted to give this advice in front, because Rupa Goswami already knowing that somehow they are going to express doubt about Guru. Somehow, there is no way, somehow they are going to express doubt in Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan. Also Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, I mean Jogmaya, arranging such a situation so they can express doubt, so that they can become disqualified in bhajan line. Somehow, Mahamaya can try to create disbelief, create some doubt inside their heart, so that they cannot do bhajan, they can fall down. This is the planning of Mayadevi all the time. All the time. So Rupa Goswami was already discussing this point, and what Sanatana Goswami was speaking also I like to discuss in details. So Rupa Goswami was speaking, suppose some Guru Vaishnava becomes sick. Externally you can see sick. Like Haridas Thakur speaking in front of Mahaprabhu. Mahaprabhu saying, how you are, Haridas? Haridas speaking, actually my asustha buddhi mon. my brain and mind are actually sick. Body is okay, little bit okay, no problem. So, susto deho, asusto buddhi mon. I cannot do harinam properly. This is my sickness. I cannot speak my harikatha. This is sickness. Nothing else. Maybe some reason can be there. Eh? So, Rupa Goswami was speaking, first of all, if one Vaishnava is from a low caste, is bad looking, very black, dirty looking, and some different kind of defects you can discover externally. But Rupa Goswami says, no, this is not actually Vaishnava Darshan. You should not look that way. Vaishnava Darshan means pure Darshan. You will have to come up to that level to reach that position. So, drishtvai sabhav janitair vapuscha dosair na prakitat tamiha bhakta janasya pasyet gangam basam na kholu budbudu fena pankai pankair brahma dabatyam apagachati nira dharmai. Actually, Rupa Goswami Bhad wanted to speak so many in details, so many, its theme is very, very nice, high class. Drishtvai sabhav janitair vapuscha dosair. If you are going to look some defects in the body of Guru Vishnava, their sickness, this, that, Satya Govinda Maharaj, he is the disciple of Prabhupada. In my life, I get this kind of unique chance to serve Guru Vishnava. Though I am material, but still they give me chance to serve. But I don't know why. I never developed this kind of material idea about Gurudev, Satya Govinda Maharaj passing urine in bed, lying. This way, all the time, our Giri Maharaj was there, Bhakti Bhavadan Sagar Maharaj, Satya Govinda Maharaj, so many, Santa Goswami Maharaj, so many Vaishnava, Bhakti Vallabha Chitta Goswami Maharaj, Guru Maharaj, all the time. They are manifesting such a leela that you can express how is possible. We see their disability, there's defects there. That is the main ground on the basis of which we can fall down. So, Rupa Goswami was first giving advice. It is actually this Upadeshamrita, Sanatana Goswami, actually Rupa Goswami was writing this Upadeshamrita to get entry into bhajan. Be careful. To get entry into Upadeshamrita, without discussing Manasiksha and Upadeshamrita, somebody doing bhajan and he becomes Siddha is absurd. I cannot believe. Is the entrance. So, Manasiksha written by Raghunath Das Goswami, Manasiksha written by our Bhaktivinoda Thakur. So, and this Rupa Goswami Pad, Upadeshamrita. Our Guru Varga speaking, it is through this Upadeshamrita and Manasiksha you can get entry into bhajan. And Sikkhastakam. Sikkhastakam you can realize when a first, second star, Sambandha Vidya Prajan Tattva, first the situation of this world, and Jiva, what is the situation, what situation they are put into, it is all there. After that, Sambandha Avidya Prajan. And not only there, but also our Guru Varga speaking, Sikkhastakam is the total, secrecy of bhajan. When you are established in bhajan, you can realize what Mahaprabhu's mood, what Mahaprabhu wanted to speak, how. This way you will have to understand Sikkhastakam is actually in bhajan secrecy. And Upadeshamrita, I'll have to, before getting entry into bhajan, you cannot get entry. And if you like to put pressure, then trespassers will be prosecuted. Some locality zone is a prohibited zone. If you forcefully like to enter into that zone, then security guard or policeman can catch you and take you into prison. Why you? Because it's a restricted zone, security zone. Why you? So this is, trespassers will be prosecuted. This is first point. So forcefully you cannot get entry. Guru Tattva, Bhagavat Tattva, Dham Tattva, Nam Tattva, Mahaprasadam Tattva, all. You cannot put your pressure. You should not try it materially. So, drishtvai svabhav janitair vapushya dosair na prakitattamiha vakta janasapasyet gangam vasam na khulu budbudu fena pankoir brahma davattam apagachyati nida dharmai. You should not find any fault with Guru Vaishnava. Maybe have Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing all in details about, and you know, so many information you can get. So actually Jiva Goswami was also writing Vishwanath Chakravarti. So they are giving, you know. So if there is any defect, suppose, you know, one bhakta is Shuddha Bhakta, but still externally you can see something, defects. Is dangerous, he cannot understand. So Rupa Goswami Pada wanted to speak that like Ganga water is also Chinmay, Aprakita. Ah, Maharaj, how possible that water is Chinmay? Is absurd? No, water is Chinmay, it's possible. Actually, our Pundarik Vidyanidhi, before starting Orsip of Salagram, he used to drink water, Ganga water, to purify himself. He is not pure. He is speaking, I am not pure. So to get purity, it was the usual rules. He used to drink one, you know, pot of water, Ganga water, first. After drinking, he start Salgam Archan. And in the daytime, usually, he was not habituated to go there in Ganga. In the daytime, he was not habituated. Usually he used to go in the nighttime. Nighttime because why? In the daytime, you can see some dead body going this, that, and some dirty thing floating in the water. So he can develop some, you know, some material conception. So usually he used to go and pay dandavat to Gangaji nighttime. So Ganga, in Ganga water there can be so many, you know, dirty thing you can find externally. But Brahma Dabatya, it is Brahma Vastu. Ganga is the water was of the lotus leg of Bamandev. So anyway it is Apragita all the time. Any situation if you see. But like this, you will have to be very, very careful that water is aprakita. Yes, water become aprakita. Water aprakita, and Vaishnava aprakita. Still, externally you can find, and water is material mara, hydrogen, oxygen, H2O. You can see, you can look this way, but it is aprakita. How possible? Then you will have to understand through Guru Kipa. Materially, if you go on, you know, putting some judgment, because I already in the starting, I told you that whenever anything you are going to think, anything you are going to, you know, understand, you will have to go to your experience bank and search. Is there any analogy you like to find some analogy? Oh, this must be this. So Guru Vaishnava, this, oh, it must be this way. So this way, always and every time, we are like to search our experience bank. Our experience bank is material experience bank. So we have no experience about this transcendental one. Aprakita yoga, what you is from our childhood or maybe in previous life. Maybe in previous life, what we have done, according to our sanskar, we can have our experience. And on the basis of that experience bank, we can consider the case, anything coming in front of us. So this is our capacity. But what we never know, we cannot see Supreme Lord. We cannot meet with Supreme Lord, we never meet before. We cannot feel, we cannot play our brain to understand this Bhagavad Tattva, Vaishnava Tattva. Then how we can understand? Then that's why Prabhupada speaking, it is Saprakas Tattva. It is self-effulgence tattva, so automatically you can feel, provided you are going to do seva under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnava. Then automatically you can come into a feeling. So inconceivable doesn't mean that never you can understand. Not that. Through seva you can gradually understand. So Rupa Goswami Pad, before starting bhajan, giving us this advice that we should not find any fault with Guru Vaishnava, Bhagavan, nothing. You should. Another point, Sanatan Goswami Pad speaking in Brihad Bhagavatamrita, say Sanatan Goswami Pad writing that Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Dohiko Vishite Tesam Panchobhotik Deho Opi Sachidananda Rupata. This sloka I can discuss. First of all, I like to give full answer to the question I already started giving answer. What is that? The how rice, dal, sabji become aprakita. Regarding this point, I would like to advise you that you can go through the sloka, through one sloka written in Gita, Srimad Bhagavad Gita, and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur, Biswanath Chakravarti giving commentary, also Bhaktivinoda Thakur giving more precise way, we know, we can know. So what is the sloka? It is actually number 4 chapter, 33 sloka. From Gita, 4 chapter, 33 sloka, you can find there one sloka. So maybe 4-5 years back, I was discussing this point somewhere, not in front of you, I forget. So, in this sloka, it is written, Sreyano dubbo mayad yagyat jnana yagya parantapa sarvam karma khilam partho jnane parisamapati. What is this sloka? Sreyano dubbo mayad yagyat jnana yagya parantapa sarvam karma khilam partho jnane parisamapati. Samapati. Follow. So, what does it mean? It means actually, O Arjun, that Gyan Yajna is more superior to any Yajna, related material things are involved in it. Any Yajna you are going to, not Karma Yajna. If I speak this Karma Yajna, it's totally different thing. You are Karma Ma Yajna, I can speak. So, I cannot speak the Karma Yajna, because Karma Yajna is a scientific term, totally different. While I am discussing Gita, I can discuss this point. But here, actually Krishna speaking, the whole Arjun, that Gyan Yajna is far superior, to Drubbamaya Yajna. Drubbamaya Yajna means any Yajna involved with material things. Material things oriented yajna, anything. And suppose we are going to arrange bandara, we are material person. In that case, it is also one kind of karma yajna. Karma yajna I cannot speak, it is a yajna related to and involved with some material things, that you can say. So, actually, Arjun sacrifice through Gyan Yajna is superior to sacrifice through Karmamaya Yajna. Karmamaya Yajna means actually things are related, material things are involved in it this much. And Karma Yajna totally separate thing. So Krishna speaking to Arjuna this way, because why? For all actions, without exception, culminate in Jnana. Everything ultimately what in this material world, when you are reading some book, when you are doing something, when you are going somewhere, you think yourself inside your mind. Ultimately, when you come back from one place, suppose you went to Darjeeling or went to New Zealand or any place, or to Himalaya, any place, or you went to some place, okay. And also suppose you are going to read some books, going to meet with some teachers or professors, everything. Ultimately you can think whatever action you are doing, it is deposited inside your mind as Gyan, experience. Though this Gyan is have some varieties of Gyan, and not mature, immature, and not at all expressed in this word, kuta avastha. So all the time in the form of experience, I mean knowledge. But it is maybe sometime it become vigyan or not vigyan. Vigyan means visheshgyan, which is within your feeling. It's called vigyan. So this way, everything in this material world, what you are reading, anything, what you are doing, or finally, if you are not going to feel something, then maybe material gyan you are going to get. But what Bhaktivinoda Thakur want to speak, that those so-called devotees, they are going to arrange some function, vandara, this, that, maybe harikatha kirtan, maybe they are going, you know, to take darshan of some ekchakradham, maybe. If they are not going under the guidance of pure Guru Vaishnav, then who is going to help them to develop that chakshu, eyes, transcendental eyes? But with material eyes, they cannot see dham. Material eyes, you know, you cannot see any transcendental thing. So Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking, that whatever you are doing, ultimately, if your chit bhavana, if your chit bhavana not coming, any yajna, suppose you are going to do sankirtan yajna, you are doing for 1 hour or 2 hours, but you will have to think yourself that after doing this 2 hours sankirtan we are doing all together, all devotees, you know, what is the net outcome? What is the net feeling you are getting? If you are going to get some material feeling, then your spiritually you are not going to get any benefit. Try to understand what whatever you are doing, whatever action, whatever harikatha, harikirtan, or vandara, anything what you are doing, you are going to do archan, anything you are doing, if you are not going to get some ultimate backing of Chit Baba, if Chit Baba not going to touch your heart, then be sure it is all material actions, nothing else. You can buy so many things, you have money, go for market, you can buy so many things. But you are doing everything. But if there is no Chit Bhav, if Chit Bhav is not expressed inside your heart, Chinmay Bhav, then all be sure, be careful that is it, then be sure it is all material actions. If you go to look Arati, if you are going to hear Harikatha from a pure sadhu, if you are going to do Sankirtan, anything you do, yeah, you are going to offer something to Krishna, anything you do, if there is no touch of Chit Bhavana, if there is no touch of Chit Bhavana, the one, what use then? What is the net outcome? It is all useless. So, what Bhaktivinoda Thakur means to say, that whatever you are doing, you must be very careful. Suppose you are going to cook something, but if it is a material, source is material, a man cooking is material, already offered material way, not doing one like Harinam, this way, all, you know, top to end, all actions become material. Then you cannot get any chit. You are doing, putting your giving and energy. You are going to give your so much energy, but ultimate result, what you are going to get? Chit. Sukrit is something you can get, but what is the net outcome? Net result? You must understand. So, not a matter of joke like Sahajiya, oh, it's all prasadam, take prasadam, this, that. You can speak this way, but you must be very intelligent to understand this point. So, how, you know, Sriyano Dubbamaya Jagyad, Jnana Yogya Parantapa, Sarvam Karma Khilam Patho Jnani Parisamapati. The ultimate result you are going to get, it can come to an end with knowledge, some knowledge. And if that knowledge is a prakita knowledge, is good. And when gyan is coming, and if that gyan get maturity, be careful. Gyan yogya, somebody going to do gyan yogya. But be careful, when this gyan get maturity, ultimately, when that gyan get maturity, it is equal to bhakti. When it is not in, you know, full-fledged form, perfect form, it is kacha, green stage, gyan yogya, then it is, you know, it is not good. But when Gyanjogya, when your Gyan become totally soft and ripe, then this is just equal to bhakti. Gyan yog become, ultimately Gyan become bhakti, is equal to bhakti. So, you will have to be very careful about that. So, without the kripa of Vishuddha Sadhu, pure Sadhu, without the kripa of Vishuddha Sadhu, pure Sadhu, there is no scope. Without the kripa of pure Sadhu, no scope, thousands of births you can do bhajan. But without the kripa of Shuddha Guru Vaishnava, you cannot come out successful. That is the main point. I wanted to say so many things in Nrisimha Chaudhari ji. What happened, you know, we'll have to think what happened, I don't know. So, I wanted to speak so many tattvas, so many. But I don't know what aparadha I have done, something unknowingly, unknowingly. That's why I couldn't, you know. So, pure sadhu, you'll have to get the kripa of all Vishuddha Guru Vaishnava. Otherwise, never, even in hundreds of life, you cannot come out successful. So, main key is the kripa of pure sadhu Guru Vaishnava. First part. Because to get the kripa of pure sadhu Guru Vaishnava is just equal to the Bhagavad kripa. Is just equal to Bhagavad kripa. If you are going to get the kripa of pure Guru Vaishnava, then it is just equal to Bhagavad kripa. Prabhupada speaking this. Also, I told you from Upanishad one sloka, why we are feeling attraction for each other or from any matter, anything. Why? Because Atma is there inside us. If Atma is not there inside your heart, then who is going to feel attraction from one lady? And who is going to feel attraction for this, that thing? So, that day I was two, three Harikatha before I was speaking. Atma ba are drashtabya srotabya nididhyasitabya. It is simply because Atma is there. That's why we give value to each other. We are going to give honor to each other simply because Atma is there. If Atma is not there, who is going to care, man? Who is going to love daughter if Atma is not there? Is going to mother going to love a son from heart? Okay. If the son is going to die, then mother going to throw that boy. So this is, so without Atma, Chinmay Atma, nothing is valuable here in this material world. So actually, now we can go and discuss this point one by one. How it is possible that Guru Vaishnava and, you know, Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, they are aprakita. From Chaitanya Charitamrita, from Chaitanya Bhagavat or Srimad Bhagavad Gita Mahapurana, I can give different kind of example. You can remember that Sanatana Goswami Pad developed some skin disease, dangerous skin disease, always bad blood and everything coming. Because Sanatana Goswami Pad coming to Purushottam Dham through Jharkhand. In Jharkhand there is no pure water. So somehow he developed this kind of skin disease which is impossible to bear. So all the time bad blood, everything coming out. And Sanatana Goswami Pad ultimately reaching Purushottam Dham. And you know all that Sanatana Rupa, whenever they are coming, when they reach up, they always try to stay such a way so that all big Vaishnava cannot touch them. So they are always thinking that we are fallen soul, so we have no right to stay in Gambira, this, that, we have no right to enter into Jagannath temple. So if they are going to express this kind of humble mood, who am I to express this kind of puffed up mood? False ego, why coming? Whereas Rupa Sanatana speaking, Haridas Thakur speaking, we have no right to enter into Jagannath. Because their Jagannath Sevak is there, we are going to touch them, I am actually contaminated, I am fallen soul. So there can be big aparadha. So this is their mood. So Sanatan Gosai Pad or Rupa Goswami, whenever they coming, they are going to take shelter into the bhajan kutir of Srila Namacharya Haridas Thakur. So this way Sanatan Gosai taking rest. But every day it is the duty of Mahaprabhu, Supreme Lord, because they are not going inside Jagannath temple. So they are not going to enter into Jagannath temple. So Jagannath himself coming to take them as there is a mood. Jagannath is there inside. So they are not going inside. So every day Mahaprabhu Jagannath going to see Luke Jagannath, same Jagannath. He is Jagannath and going to see Jagannath. But after coming back from Jagannath temple, while he was coming back, daily Mahaprabhu going to take darshan of Haridas Thakur. To be frank, not to give darshan. It is a Mahaprabhu speaking, darshane pavitra karo hei tumar khu. Bhakti Mataku speaking, if one pure Vaishnava not going to speak anything, still, if you look at pure Vaishnava, we can become pure. That kind of power is there in them. So we cannot believe it. This is the disease, you know. So Mahaprabhu coming to see Haridas Thakur and Sanatan. Not that like Dhruva Maharaj. It is written in Bhagavatam that Prabhu Narayan coming to see his small devotee. Prabhu coming Madbhakta Dadarshaha. I am going there to see my devotee. Not that I am going to show. I am going not going to give darshan to my devotee. Not that way. Regarding, you know, Dhruva Maharaj written, Prabhu speaking, I am going to take darshan of my very, you know, small devotee. There's this kind of thing. So Prabhu daily coming in the morning time to see Sanatan or to see Haridas Thakur, everything. But every day, Mahaprabhu going to embrace Sanatan. Sanatan crying, why you are going to touch me? Mahaprabhu going to embrace him. Sanatan running backside. But Mahaprabhu forcefully take him and lap and embrace. And all bad blood, poil, actually all coming into the body of that Mahaprabhu. And Sanatan crying, Prabhu, don't touch me actually. I am actually this kind of disease, all body actually. You shouldn't touch me, Prabhu. Then Prabhu not going to obey. So one day Sanatan took decision to give the body under the wheel of Jagannath Ratha. Sanatan took decision, well, every day Prabhu coming and forcefully touching me. So I am getting aparad daily. So it is good that I can leave my body, Ratha Yatra coming in front. During Ratha Yatra, I can jump in, I can throw myself under the wheel of Jagannath, is very good. Then Mahaprabhu, Jagannath himself, so Mahaprabhu coming here, Sanatan, what is your judgment? What? What do you mean? Why you are going to, if you think that if we can leave our body, then we can get Jagannath, Mahaprabhu speaking, I can throw my body hundreds and thousands of times. If I can get Jagannath, then I can leave body all the time. Don't think that way. If I am going to die, I cannot get Jagannath. You have to do bhajan, na? Nitya Parshad, but still Mahaprabhu teaching us. So Mahaprabhu speaking to Haridas, Haridas, see, if some property I am going to keep with you, you have your power to spend that money or anything, but no, it is deposited by somebody. So why he is going to throw his body under the wheel of Jagannath? It is my property. Your body is now my property. Why you are going to take decision? You have no right to take decision. You have no right to take decision. Why you are going to take decision? Because your body is now my property. I can do so many. I can get so many seva by the help of this body. I can get so many seva. I am planning. But you like to die? Why? It's not proper. You should not take. then Mahaprabhu ultimately going to again embrace Sanatan and then make the body as it was before. Then Mahaprabhu started speaking. Mahaprabhu speaking, you can go through Chaitanya Charitamrita, you can find. Prabhu kahe Vaishnav sarir prakito kabhu nahi. Mahaprabhu speaking, Vaishnav sarir, maybe there is some disease, something, but it is not prakito, it is not material. Prabhu speaking, Vaishnav sarir prakito kabhu nahi. Vaishnav sarir is never material body, it's transcendental of prakito. Now you are explaining, again you are speaking this way, how we can understand? Now, this is the point. This is the point, how we can understand that. So, Sanatana Gosai going to give this sloka in Brihad Bhagavatamrita. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Dahi Kavisrite Tesham Panchobhutik Dehopi Sachidananda Rupata. Is that Siddhanta, perfect Siddhanta of Sanatana Gosai path? On the basis of this Siddhanta, we are going to discuss all these topics. So, Sanatana Gosai path speaking, Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat. If you go on drinking Krishna Bhakti Ras, if you are going to drink Krishna Bhakti Ras Sudha, Sudha means Amrita. Because Amrita means nectar, but nectar, there was fighting between demons and demigods for this Amrita. But that Amrita is not useful for us. It has some magic spell, but up to certain limit. It can make your body, diseaseless. No disease can be there. Your young age you can maintain this, that, or Amrita. But anyway, Amrita means you are not going, this Amrita cannot give you result. But Krishna speaking in Srimad Bhagavatam, that Mai Bhakti Ri Bhutanam Amrita Taya Kalpati. Amrita, mortality and immortality. Immortality, how you can get? Krishna speaking through Bhakti. Mai bhakti hi bhutanam amrito taya kalpate. Through my bhakti, pure bhakti, is amrita. So you are never going to die. Still today, some pure devotee, they can see Sanatana Gosai Pad doing bhajan in bhajan kutir. How is that possible? Whereas we can find the body of Sanatana inside. So many cases in Barsana, here, there, so many cases. So many cases there, that sadhu already gone from this material world. Still, sometimes some pure sadhu can see them. Hari Baba is there doing bhajan in bhajan kutir. It's not ghost. If you think they are ghost, it's wrong. They are not ghost. It is written Siddhanta, jivan mukto opi, you are totally transcend this material world, gone. Still, they can again come and show you same body. Sanatana Gosai, still today, pure devotees, they can see Sanatana Gosai path, Rupa Gosai path, Jiva Gosai path, Raghunath Das ways. It depends according to their bhajan power. They can see. Now my question is that how one sadhu can see Sanatana Gosai, whereas already his body is there inside samadhi? Now my question is that you have to give answer. How you can give? So Sanatana Gosai was speaking, Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Daihi Kavishrite Tesam Panchabhautik Deho Pi Sachidananda Rupata. Externally you can find that their body is built up of five elements of this nature. Khiti, Apamo, Tej, Marut, Bom. All bodies you can find. Even Supreme Lord, when coming here, his total body is transcendental of Prakrit. But still, if Jagai Mata is going to strike on the head of Nityananda, we can find that blood coming. तो महाराज नित्यानंद बॉडी इज मेड अप ऑफ ब्लड एंड फ्लेश, सो व्हाई वी कैन से हाउ वी कैन से दैट इज आई नो एक्चुअली बलदेव जी महाराज, दैट इज अ क्वेश्चन. कृष्ण इज देयर इन इन फ्रंट ऑफ पितामह भीष्म, फाइटिंग गोइंग ऑन. समटाइम पितामह भीष्म इन इज यू नो लास्ट यू नो स्टेटमेंट, पितामह भीष्म स्पीकिंग, I am thinking this, you know, this that picture is there inside my heart. From your body blood coming out, sweat coming out, you are jumping from the chariot, you know, taking up the wheel, broken wheel of a chariot. I think, and all your clothes are flying in the sky. You jump from the rat, you know. गत उत्तरियो पितामह भीष्म स्पीकिंग. सो समटाइम आई एम यू नो थ्रोइंग माई एरो इन योर ब्लड कमिंग आउट ऑफ योर बॉडी. सो इन भागवतम इट इज रिटन ऑल्सो कृष्ण बाल लीला, कृष्ण समटाइम मेकिंग मड एनो स्टूल यूरिन दिस दैट. सो महाप्रभु ऑल्सो इन गंभीरा मंदिर गोइंग आई एम गोइंग टू शौचालय, शौचालय मीन इन यू नो आउटसाइड. सो लघु शंका गुरु शंका इन प्योर यू नो साधु दे आर स्पीकिंग दिस वे. लघु शंका यू नो यू आर गोइंग टू यू नो बाथरूम. सो महाप्रभु स्पीकिंग दैट डजंट व्हाट डू यू मीन दिस. सो यू कैन थिंक दिस महाप्रभु इज मेटेरियल, महाप्रभु मेटेरियल, यू कैन थिंक दिस वे. बट इट इज क्वाइट नेचुरल व्हेन भगवान कमिंग इन दिस मेटेरियल वर्ल्ड. Be careful. When Narayan coming, Narayan can come and give darshan and vanish. You can find. Narayan can come like, you know, Devaki Vasudev. When in front of Devaki Vasudev, Narayan coming with forehand and club and wheel, everything, Sankha, conch, everything, they are actually praying, Prabhu, you coming? Who? After that, they are praying. No question of love, or love, affection, you know. Actually, in Bengali we say, sneho nimnogami. Affection always flowing downwards. You cannot show affection to me, but I can show affection to you. Because affection is always going down from up. So affection, father, mother, Guru Vaishnav can show affection, but you cannot show affection to Guru Vaishnav. Not possible. This is the point. So Devaki Vasudev thinks, oh, it's the original cause of all causes, Supreme Lord coming here. So Maharaj, they are praying so much sloka. Oh, yes. Then it is written in Chaitanya Charitamrita, Aishwarya Shithil Preme Nahi Marpito. If there is Aishwarya Gyan, you know, affluences, Aishwarya Gyan, then Priti, love affair cannot stand. Then one comes avi. Avi mean your love mixed with some fear, sweet fear. Avi, oh Prabhu is there, this way. But when Krishna, if you like to do bhajan of Krishna, first of all you should understand how to do bhajan, so that Krishna become your friend, Krishna become your husband. What is the actual procedure? But so long you are going to have that kind of, you know, dirty darshan, you cannot have the scope to look Guru Vaishnav, to what to speak about Bhagavan. If the day you can feel, who is Krishna? Krishna and I am myself, same, no problem. Tumi ami samo, it is written in Chaitanya, you know, those sakha, those friends, they say, who are you? Oh, you same, you are my friend. They never think that way. That is Krishna, Supreme Lord, these are. If Supreme Lord coming in this material world in the form of Narayan, then he can come and vanish from you. So better you can do bhajan of Narayan. So you need not express this kind of doubt, how possible the parsadas of, you know, Gaurang Mahaprabhu, they have the samadhi. You cannot find any samadhi of Narayan parsad there in Vaikuntha. So it's good. So my question is that Narayan coming here, giving you darshan and going up. What is the speciality with Mahaprabhu? What is the speciality with Krishna? Because they are going to do some special leela. If Krishna going to distribute rasa, then it is not possible if Krishna going to show like Narayan. If Krishna going to show same mood like Narayan, then you cannot exchange prema, lava. How you can exchange? The excellency lying with some, maybe in, if I am going to live more than in Purushottam Vrata and Kartik Vrata, I like to cover this point. That how excellency of Krishna, different lila, right from the birth up to end, what kind of excellency there? The excellency of lila can, excellency of lila we can feel when Supreme Lord is Supreme Lord, Krishna is there, same Krishna. He is Anadi Radhi Govinda Sarvakaranuka, but still, just like human being. Just same like human being. If this kind of condition is not fulfilled, then exchange of rasa is not possible. Exchange of rasa is only possible when Supreme Lord Krishna is there, Anadi Radhi Govinda, there is no cause of Govinda, is the original root cause. But still, he is going to show same, just like a human being. That is called excellency of Leela. Narayan cannot say in front of you, ah, I'm feeling appetite, no, you give me something. Krishna can speak, so you can enjoy. So this way, each and every Leela I can discuss someday, you can feel that when Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan aprakita, transcendental. But still when they are coming here in this material world to play, just like Manushya Vigraham, just like human being, just like same, Krishna going to pass urine, Yashodama going to clean, crying, as a feeling appetite, I will have to give breast milk, and the boy, crying. If Krishna not going to play that way, who is going to care, man? What kind of excellency we can get? So all Guru Vaishnava and Bhagavan, they are coming here, but there is some different. What Sanatana Goswami want to speak, Ya Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Dahi Kabisirte. Try to understand this point. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat. You go on hearing Harikatha, you go on hearing Harikatha, you go on hearing Harikatha. Drinking. Ultimately, you are going to forget all your body and body related things. Follow what I say. All your body and body related things all missing now. Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat. But it should be Sudha. Don't misunderstand. Try to maintain purity. Don't allow anybody to touch Vaisasan somehow, unknowingly. Some contamination there. Then pure thing, you cannot expect. Big problem can be there. Because Vaisasan and everything, all worship room, all should be, there should not be any. All that. That is why Guru Vaishnava swaying as Acharan. What do you mean by acharan? To maintain purity. To get in touch with that Supreme Lord, always we must maintain purity. Always, every time. Aerial connection. If you impurity, then connection can cut. Big problem. Inside there, externally you cannot find. Then big problem can be there. So be careful about that. So Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat. First of all, it should be Krishna Bhakti from the lotus mouth of pure Guru Vaishnava, who himself established in Tattva all the time. He is in bhajan. So Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat. Panat mane, when go on drinking. One, like I can give the example of Parikshit Maharaj. When Parikshit Maharaj was given this information, oh Maharaj, take preparation, because within 7 days you are going to die. Samik Muni, there, send information. Now Parikshit Maharaj taking preparation. Khatanga Raja was taking preparation within a very short interval of time. And we have no surety how long we are going to live. So we are going to take risks. Why? Why not start bhajan all the time? Non-stop bhajan should be there. So Parikshit Maharaj is not at all material. But why? Because in Bhagavatam 3-4 place, I can show you 3-4 place, where it is written about Parikshit Maharaj, Esho Mahabhagavatah. About Parikshit Maharaj, 3-4 places. When Parikshit Maharaj took birth, in his horoscope it is written, after there so many rishimunis and there, this, that, so many. 3-4 times. Passing remark, we can find in Bhagavatam, Esho Mahabhagavatah. He is Mahabhagavat. So what do you mean by Mahabhagavat? What is the symptom of Bhagavat? What is the symptom of Bhagavat? I can discuss someday. Mahabhagavat means he is always, you know, thinking about Supreme Lord. Always doing seva of Supreme Lord. But still, to give us example, Sukadeva Goswami is speaking in front of Parikshit Maharaj. O Rajan, tvam tu marishye iti achintvayam. O Rajan, you are going to die, you are going to die, you are going to die. You will have to think over and again this point. Don't forget. Why? To catch his attention. Be careful. That doesn't mean Parikshit Maharaj, Mahabhagavad is written, what is the symptom? So many symptoms are there about Mahabhagavatam. So Mahabhagavatam, we cannot expect that Mahabhagavatam is material. Then Sukadeva Goswami, why speaking this way? That tam tu marishe iti atincha, hey Rajan, you can die. Please try to think over and again. Why? To catch his full attention. To catch his full attention. Because young age, he lives with the total kingdom. What to speak about? Whole world is going to rule. Going to leave everything. All the treasures there, wives there, children there, all in young age. But still, Mahabhagavat in Mahabhagavat. Bhaktivinoda Thakur was in family life. Srinivasacharya was in family life. Sivasacharya was in family life. Who not? But still, for our teaching, Sukadeva Goswami going to give this advice to Parikshit Maharaj, Rajan, you are going to die. Please try to think it over and again. Tvam tu marishye Rajan iti achintayo. You go on thinking, you are going to die, you are going to die, you are going to die. Why? To catch his full attention to Harikatha. Because submission shown by Parikshit Maharaj, total submission. If there is no submission, 100% submission, why Sukadeva Goswami can take trouble to speak Harikatha, marathon Harikatha, non-stop Harikatha, 7 days and nights, days and nights. So continuously. But one spectacular thing is there. When the Harikatha was over, when Sukadeva Goswami going to take leave, then Sukadeva Goswami, same Sukadeva Goswami again giving advice to Rajan, Parikshit Maharaj, Rajan, tvam tu marishye iti pashubuddhi mimam johi. He Rajan, tvam tu marishye pashubuddhi mimam johi. He Rajan, you are going to die. This kind of beastly conception, this kind of pashu buddhi, beastly conception should be cut. There should not be this kind of beastly conception inside your heart that you are going to die because you are not body. Then it is my question. Same Sukadeva Goswami is speaking just before Harikatha speaking. As if it seems that the body of Parikshit Maharaj is material. But after Harikatha is over, when Sukadeva Goswami is going away, going to give the final advice, tvam tu marishye Rajan pashubuddhi mimam johi, this kind of beastly conception should be avoided. Why? Because after Harikatha Sravan, hearing Harikatha, Harinam Kirtan, how it is possible to maintain material body? If you are at all going to maintain material body, surely you are not going to take pure prasadam, you are not going to hear pure Harikatha, you are not going to do Harinam Sankirtan purely, nothing. A symptom. So Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat, on hearing Harikatha from the lotus mouth of Guru Vaishnava, your body can become Chinmay. If you are already from Nitya Jagat, Nitya Parshad, that is different. Even if you are going to get Siddhi, Bhajan Siddhi this life, through Harinam Sankirtan everything, still your body become Chinmay. Now again we can express doubt, because I already told how it's possible. Nityananda Prabhu, when Jagai Mata is going to strike on the head, we see blood coming out. When Mahaprabhu, you know, there in Gambira temple at night time, running here and there, cannot get space to get out, and dashing, pushing with mouth, everything, nose, cutting, and blood coming out. So this way, how is possible they are swaying this way? I already told, if they are coming here in this material world to do this kind of leela, to exchange rasa, everything, if they are not going to act just like a human body, then we cannot get enjoyment. Not possible. You can remember, Mahaprabhu already speaking in front of Sanatana Goswami in Sanatana Sikha. In Sanatana Sikha, Mahaprabhu giving advice to Sanatana, Sanatana, be careful. All these, you know, Krishna Antadhyan, when Krishna disappear from this material world, Krishna Antadhyan, Mahishi Haran, all the abduction, all those Mahishis, Jadu Vamsa destiny, Jadu destiny destroyed, all Mayamoy, all done by, it is one kind of magic spell by Yogamaya, not Mahamaya. Mayamaha, Mahamaya, she has no access here. It is not done by Mahamaya. I can also, in the Ramnavami day, I was speaking Harikatha. Then I already told that day, when Ravan going to abduct Sita Devi, we find in Raman. So how it is possible? Sita Devi is not ordinary woman, so that you can go and abduct her. Sita Devi is a Shakti, Sarup Shakti. Sarup Shakti is non-different from Supreme Lord Ram. It is non-different. How it is possible for Ravan to abduct Sita Devi? Bhagavan Sri Krishna Chaitanya speaking, no, not at all possible. Actually, Ravan going to abduct Maya Sita. It was forwarded by Maya. It was forwarded by Maya Devi. Sita Devi entered into Agni, and Agni Devi going to put some Maya Sita. So Ravan going to abduct just to play the whole leela. Ramchandra was doing that way. If at all Sita is not abducted, then why? What's the reason of going there, killing, fighting with Ravan? This, that, why? What? Material people are so poisonous. Material people are so dangerous. Material people. Rupa Goswami was speaking, hey Prabhu, you can give me any kind of punishment, but please don't keep me among material people. Please, it is my request. Barang hutabha jala panjarantar vyavasthitihi. Oh Prabhu, you can do one thing if you want to give me punishment. You can set fire all around and put me inside the case, and all around you can set fire. I can get so much, you know, hit. That also I can bear, but I cannot bear material association. But all around you, all material association. In the name of, you know, satsanga, you are doing all material association. So sometime you are doing satsangas, all the time, asatsanga. So how to be very clever to avoid asatsanga? I was speaking, patibhata ramani pati lagi koilo beshas sevan. Again, next day I can discuss this point. What is the tactics? Prabhupada speaking, you should be very clever. You should be very clever to cheat all material people and engage yourself in Hari Bhajan. What is that tactics? I can discuss. So Rupa Goswami was praying in front of Supreme Lord Prabhu, material association, please don't keep me. I fear material association, but we are always going outside here all the time. We are looking material, we are thinking material, we are touching material, doing material. Good day again, getting the association material person all the time. So how to save yourself? Is one kind of secret technique through which you can protect yourself all the time. Material people so dangerous. They are so idiot. They always try to express doubt about the aprakita humbleness of Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami. When Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is speaking that jagai madhai hoite muishe papishto purisher kit hoite muishe logishto mor naam jei loy tar punno tar pap hoy mor naam jei shune tar punno khoy. Then material philosophers, those are idiot, doctorate, they have done doctorate. They have taken doctorate degree from Calcutta University here and there. They are speaking, Maharaj, actually, Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami is going to identify himself. So fallen soul. So what necessary we are going to waste our time to discuss all his philosophy? Whereas he, I'm already going to speak that I am a fallen. Pope are speaking, they are idiot, foolish, they don't understand. The more you are going up and up, the more you can develop humbleness. The more you are going up and up in your bhajan, you can show your inability. I am useless actually. I have no bhajan, nothing. This way you have to cry. This means your bhajan is perfect. And also Supreme Lord can test you, can create such a situation, you are 100% going to misunderstand. It is the arrangement of Maya, Mahamaya can arrange. So that you can misunderstand and fall down. Is a Jogmaya sometime doing something, sometime Mahamaya doing. So when you see, when Lakshmanji Maharaj was defeated by, Meghnad, then everybody laughing. Michael Madhusudan Datta, material kavi. Michael Madhusudan, how he became Michael? You know it very well. And before death, he is crying, you give me Charanamrita of Radha Krishna. Are, why you leave this society and go to England to take Christian Dharma? And now at the end of life, when he is going to die, give me some Charanamrita of Radha Krishna. Now, you come back to your point, foolish. He is speaking, he writing Meghnad Bhat Kabba, those material, those who are doing MA class in Calcutta, here and there, they are reading this, Meghnad Kabya. Through Meghnad Kabya, epic, Kabya, they are going to take decision that Lakshman is useless. Lakshman is defeated by Meghnad. I was very angry to read it. Hari, he is Lakshman, Supreme Lord. Maharaj, he is actually defeated by Meghnad. No, foolish people. In this transcendental world, aprakita jagat, if you want to get exact information, you will have to approach pure Sadhguru Vaishnava. Lakshman was not at all defeated by Meghnad. It was the arrangement. Brahma giving this kind of benediction, so to fulfill the benediction of Brahma, Lakshman playing that way. You can remember in Mahabharata, you can find in Mahabharata, this Kurukshetra Yuddha going on. Ashwatthama praying to Mahadev, doing bhajan, austerity and penance are so heavy. Mahadev bound to come. Mahadev speaking, what you want? Actually, I like to kill Arjun. Mahadev saying, not possible. No, you will have to give, no, but not possible. I can give you benediction, one day you can defeat Arjun. One day only, for some time. One day, for some time, you can defeat Arjun. I can create this situation. But it is not possible that you can defeat Yudhishthira Mahadev, is that, but you cannot defeat Arjun, not possible. Okay, one time. So this kind of, benediction ultimately going against themselves, praying this way, that way. Mahadev was very clever, giving benediction in such a way that he is thinking, I am not going to die, but that actually they are very clever. They are going to give you benediction, keeping in reservation some points through which, like Hiranyakasipu. Hiranyakasipu, how is going to think, nobody can kill me, but Bhagavan is very clever, you know. So this way, those material, you know, poets and, you know, those who are big, big learned men from Calcutta University here, they are going to pass a remark that Lakshman is defeated by Meghnad. They are going to pass, you know, they are getting, I am very, you know, surprised to see how it is possible that the rector of Calcutta University, all the chancellor, they are going to give doctorate degree to those idiot. They are going to do some research on Chaitanya Mahaprabhu and passing remark that Nimai actually Gauranga Mahaprabhu going for love marriage. Gauranga Mahaprabhu going to love marriage with first marriage was there, second marriage. So idiot number one. They are going to get, you know, from university this kind of degree. They're doing research. We are going to pass urine and stool on that research copy. Whereas they are idiot chancellor and this, they are, how they can pass this kind of, you know, they have no brain at all. Eh? They're passing. Also, one, you know, research fellow, after doing research, they are getting doctorate degree and they are going to final decision that Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was beaten to death by Panda inside Jagannath temple. And one skeleton was also found, a tall figure. So now you think, how we can expect that material world can do bhajan, whereas you are also in this material society, you are not going to get actual sadhu sangha. So without actual sadhu sangha, I cannot expect that you can cut your ignorance. I cannot expect that you can cut your doubts. Not possible, but you are bound to stay there in your own country and, you know, do this kind of activities, which is all material. Aprakita Chinmaya, step by step I am discussing so that you have no scope to misunderstand me. They are so idiot. They are going to pass this kind of remark. That Chaitanya Mahaprabhu was beaten to death by Jagannath Pandas. Then from Devananda Gorimat, Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, I am very happy. Why I love Bhaman Goswami Maharaj so much? Bhaman Goswami Maharaj took the trouble to give answer, to throw chappal on their face. Bhaman Goswami Maharaj, in very polite form, giving answer to them. What is the mystery of Antadhyan Rasa? So you should take all those things, you know. So first of all, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, how disappear? Somebody looking the Chaitanya Mahaprabhu running into Jagannath temple, and Jagannath temple become closed and disappear. Somebody looking Chaitanya Mahaprabhu running towards sea and disappear. Somebody going to see Jaya Mahaprabhu running into Totakapinath and, you know, submerged with Totakapinath. Nityanandapur submerged with Bhakya Rai there. So this way, Advaita Gosai. So you see, first of all, when Sanatana Gosai is speaking, you should believe it. Minimum belief should be there. And to cut total dissatisfaction, to cut total doubts, you will have to approach pure Sadhu Guru Vaishnava. Because until and unless they are going to realize this point from heart, how they can give you satisfaction? Material argument not going to satisfy you. Some material pandit can give some material argument, but material argument cannot satisfy you. So those who are totally established in tattva, those who are doing 100% bhajan all the time in transcendental world, they are, you know, they can cut your ignorance, they can cut your, you know, doubt, misconception. So you will have to approach them. But you are busy with, you think you are Siddha Mahatma. you going to deliver others? Whereas corona disease is there with you, how you can deliver others? Eh? If your disease is not, you know, still there, if you going to deliver another, you know, another bonded soul, how is possible? A man who is not expert in swimming, if you want to deliver a man who is going to drown into river, eh? Then both of them can go down inside water, they can die. So this Math Mandir, everything all established by Prabhupada, everything, Bhaktivinoda, is only for the reason that is a desire of Prabhupada. Prabhupada wanted to make mobile Gauriya Math. Prabhupada always wanted to make mobile Gauriya Math. They can cut dissatisfaction, they can cut all doubts and dissatisfaction. But unluckily, we are running just opposite way. At all, if you like to run your mat, if this is your goal, then what you can expect? If this is your goal, Maharaj, how to run mat? Okay. If this is your goal, to run a mat, then you run your mat. But if you're staying in Gauriya Math, if you're staying with Guru Bhargava, means to get realization, to go up in bhajan, and ultimately you like to get nitya seva, then how you can go? How you can get nitya seva? Because your target is to run a mat somehow, by hook and crook. Oh Maharaj, who can worship? Let him worship. Ali Maharaj, he is a material man. His bed is not pure every day. His bed is, you know, contaminated. How we can expect him to enter into temple, into Jagannath temple, into temple and worship? And material people, when going to establish deity, be sure, don't go to pay dandavat to that deity. Any material acharya going to establish any deity, any temple, don't go there. It is the advice of Srila Ramanujacharya. Ramanujacharya speaking, Prapanna Jivanamitam, everything you can get, so nice books. So, any material temple established by any material person, material deities, material Shivlinga, you need not pay dandavat to their deity. You need not pay dandavat. Those deities already established by some Mahapurush, elevated big Siddha Mahatma, maybe 800 years back, 1000 years back, maybe 500 years back, maybe 100 years back. And that deities are being worshipped, non-stop worshipping going on, and pure devotee is going to do Sankirtan, Nam, Sankirtan, everything. You can expect. Even it can happen so, after Shuddha Mahatma, Sadguru Dev gone, if the present Acharya is going to make the temple total Saturday club, material society, he like to arrange all material person, everything, all material. He himself is material. In that case, there can be so much, you know, nonsense in the temple. He is going to give diksha, but that diksha is not perfect diksha. They are going to enter into temple, doing worship, touching vigra, all nonsense going on. After that, what can happen? If the deity is very dissatisfied, then from deity, Supreme Lord can go away. Ramanujacharya speaking, sometimes if there is so much, you know, babichar, babichar means all different kind of operation, all, you know, nonsense going on. You know, no purity, nothing. They are doing all rubbish. In that case, from deity, Supreme Lord can go away. Though it was established by the Supreme Lord, some big sadhu, but due to this kind of dirty situation, like hell, he can go different temples in Vrindavan. They wanted to establish themselves, I am Gauranga. You can go night time, you can find those ladies and gents, all, you know, boys and girls, they are dancing, like Saturday club. That's why so many people. So much people, so many people, even sannyasi. Even sannyasi, they are staying in Gaudiya Math for past 40 years. They are going to take the same, Maharaj, why you go, why you keep, why is very nice. Why we cannot take darshan in Delhi, in Vrindavan, they are going, Mayavadi. They are going to take darshan of that temple. This is the situation. So Ramanujacharya speaking, if there is no life, if there is no life, you know, in any deity, already gone, due to this kind of, nonsense, vigraha, from vigraha, Krishna, Radharani, Gauranga already gone. Suppose one big sadhu, great sadhu, today somehow he is going to pay dandavat to that deity. Then immediately life can come, I mean Krishna. When that, deity made of stone or, brass, gold become full of life, vigraha nao tumi sakshat brajananda. You will have to think this point. You are not putting this question, oh Maharaj, one deity is made of stone and, sometimes brass, sometimes gold. So it's all matter. So why you are going to worship? Why you open temple? If it is established by one sadhu, big sadhu, pure sadhu, then be sure, then it is not material, doll. It's just because vigraha nao tumi sakshat brajananda. How it is possible for Gopal, Sakshi Gopal, to come from Vrindavan? Sakshi Gopal is deity there. But by the request of Choto Vipra, small Brahman, he was bound to come walking. And is coming here. After that, going to speak, giving Sakshi witness. Now it is my question, how it is possible? Vigraha, Choto Vipra speaking to Gopal, Gopal, in front of you, that Bara Vipra, elder Vipra, he promised you, but now he is not going to keep his promise. So you will have to go with me as a witness. Krishna speaking, how it is possible to go there? Vigraha never walking. Choto Vipra speaking, Vigraha, you deity can speak, deity cannot go. If deity can speak, deity can also go. Then Krishna is defeated. Well, every day you can give 1 kg rice to me, cook, and don't look at me. If you look at me, I can stay in that place. You cannot move me. Okay. Then that deity coming and speaking in front of public, this is called Bhaktavasal Hari. Out of love, Krishna can do anything. What Krishna cannot speak? What Krishna cannot do? Krishna can do anything. What Krishna can do? Anything. Krishna can speak anything. It is possible. So, deity, vigraha nao tumi sakshat bhajananam. As deity, it is written that deity is just equal to Supreme Lord. How? Krishna is omnipresent. And specially Krishna going to take rest inside the heart of Guru Vaishnava. That's why we are going to love Guru Vaishnava so much. I can discuss this point next day. So first of all, try to understand this point. That vigraha coming here, vigraha, if some material person going to establish vigraha, then it is written by Ramanujacharya, that is not at all vigraha, it is idol. But when one Mahapurush is going to install one deity, then it has become Supreme Lord Himself. Out of His love, He is going to promise that from today onward, I am established here, you are going to do seva, I am going to take all seva from you. That is called vigraha. Vigraha means vishesh special vigraha. And by special mercy, can be shown to you by deities. That is called vigraha, a special mercy you can get. Because Krishna is not going to speak anything. And in South India, one Vipra is very poor. He heard that some if somebody can worship mentally, still he can do offer anything. I'm very poor, I cannot offer. So what to do? He started serving Supreme Lord, sitting at the bank of Godavari Nadi, or mental seva. But not that it is not prescribed for you. You have money, lot of money, you will have to arrange, book everything. But a poor man, Brahmin, he started worshipping. He arranged flower and fruits, everything. He cooked paramanna, everything, offering to Krishna, getting the same result. But if you are not going to do, if you say, my example is there, there is called Vitta Satya. It is one kind of operat. It is not prescribed for you. It is prescribed for pure Guru Vaishnava. Those who have no money, nothing, niskinchan for them. So you see, that Vipra started worshipping and he cooking paramanna. One day, he cooked paramanna, keep in a very nice pot, silver pot. After some time, he doing sankirtan, this, that, kirtan, nam. He wanted to check up that the paramanna is by now cool down or not. I can offer to Krishna, copper to Prabhu or not. He wanted to check. He put his finger inside that paramanna. Ah, is burnt up. When he opened his dhyan meditation, he find really his hand is, you know, burnt up. And Prabhu, they are laughing in Vaikuntha, in front of Lakshmi. So this way is possible. So how it is possible, I can discuss. Maybe one or two or three class I can discuss Harikatha, so that you can understand. By the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, by the mercy of Guru Vaishnava, pure Guru Vaishnava, only you can grow that kind of feeling that it is not idol, it is vigraha. It is not rice and dal, sabji, it is prasadam. It is not, you know, material village, it is dham. It is not material sound, it is harinam. That you can realize when? The day you can feel that my Gurudev is just equal to Gauranga Mahaprabhu. You can get the scope to serve. And through serving and doing harinam under the guidance of Guru Vaishnava, someday you can get this scope very quickly. Harinam, Hari, like, you know, Krishna speaking in front of Brahma. First of all, Brahma wanted to try his best to know the secrecy of this, you know, lotus. Where from I am coming? What is the source of this lotus? Brahma was very chanchal, wanted to go inside the stem. Thousands of years is going to lose. Again, after that, you hear from water, tapa, tapa, tapa. Then, Yogamastita, he started doing tapasya. Then Bhagavan speaking Chatusraki Bhagavatam. You cannot know. You can play your brain. You can, you know, try your best. It is not possible for you. Javan ham yatha bhava yad rupa guna karma kaha tathiva vijnanamastu te madanu grahat. By my mercy, you can know. Javan ham yatha bhava yad rupa guna karma kaha tathiva vijnanamastu te madanu grahat. Aham yavasame vagriyam nanyajya sahasatma. This slok you can see. So this way, dam, nam, sarup, leela, everything Brahma could realize by the mercy of Supreme Lord. It was a special case. But Supreme Lord not going to show you kripa directly. So through Guru Vaishnava, you will have to get kripa. And kripa, if you are going to the Maharaj, give me kripa, you cannot get. Even without asking, you can get kripa. Even if you are long distance, you are staying long away from Guru Vaishnava, still they have their transcendental eyes. They can see what you are doing, what you are disbelief, what they can do kripa. If at all there is demand, then supply can be made. It is a formula of economics. If there is no demand, there cannot be supply. If you at all demand is there, you want to get kripa, you want to die without Krishna, without Prabhu Seva, then surely you can get kripa. If you are going to make some compromise, if you are going to compromise with good and bad, material and transcendental all, then never you are going to get. So this kind of, you know, discretion, this kind of vichakhanata should be there. Very should, you should be very clever how to keep balance between this transcendental one and prajnaparamita. Be very careful, otherwise you are going to miss your bhajan. Be careful all the time. So Krishna Bhakti Sudha Panat Deho Dehika Visrite Tesam Panchabhutik Dehopi Sachidananda Rupata. I can discuss this slok next day. Only I can say Tesam Panchabhutik Dehopi. Externally you can find Guru Vaishnava, their body is in a, made of five elements like you. But it is not material. How it is possible? Then I can discuss next day. So, under the guidance of Srila Prabhupada, his vichar, we like to discuss all these points, you know. So, we are ever grateful to Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. Otherwise, who can, you know, dismantle our, you know, this kind of ignorance? This is a big point. Sujanar budaradito padu jugam jugadharma durandara patrubadam varadavayodaya kapuya padam panamami sadaprabhu padu padam panamami sadaprabhu padu padam panamami sadaprabhu padu padam vanchakalpadu vasyaki basindu bhavacha patitanam pavanam bhavishnabhyo namo namo.